found 3 broken bones in his toes. Yesterday during the street practice, Matt landed wrong off of a jump and felt his toes bend back. He toughed it out all night long, went to the doctor this morning, and the doctor's diagnosis, you're done for the competition. But true to Matt's form, his diagnosis was no cast, a little Advil, and a little tape, and he's not even ruling himself out of the vert competition.
I really love dirt, right, vert? You know, that's my passion. Street and dirt, you know, it's kind of a fun sport, and I just have to get hurt on the streets. I'm hoping to nurse it as well as I can, and maybe there's a possibility I can ride dirt. I don't know. It won't be my best performance, but at least I can do something and compete with all the other guys.
And it'd be a shame not to see him there. He's worked so hard, and Hoffman has really taken bicycle stunts to a new level through his competitions and the exposure that has gotten on TV. But some of the guys don't really want that much exposure. They want to keep the sport at the grassroots level and feel that his events have made the sport too competitive. But as it changes, some guys are going to be left behind.
Unfortunately, Matt will be left behind as the other riders attack the street course. I mean, street course attacks back. You'll see what we mean as we pick up prelims with Jack Edwards and Paul Higgins.
It is a health insurance agent's worst nightmare. The street course for bicycle stunt at the Newport Yachting Center. 10 times in a row, overall world champion, Dennis McCoy from Kansas City. He's been thrown back into it.
Competitor 90 seconds at a time. They get 2 runs in these prelims. They're judged on a 100-point scale. The top 8 average scores of 2 runs advance to the final.
Bicycle Stunt Street. Off the goal to master maneuvers while attacking a street course of ramps, launches, and quarter pipes. Scoring is based on the judges' overall impression. The score granted difficult tricks and creative combinations will hit the mark. The best runs will take a line through the course that takes advantage of all the obstacles and displays a variety of tricks. Going for the impossible may cause fall, but won't stop them from becoming king of the street.
Overlooking Newport Harbor, it is Jay Miron. The Canadian beast. He has a sister. She's a nurse. I see this occupation.
Hard in the left leg, but he's still got caught twice now, the 540. His left foot came off when he came down the quarter pipe. But he did pull off a bar spin over the sub box. With a two-tail up on the sub box, which is very difficult, depending on that butt head.
Judges scoring 1-100.
There are
two first-round runs on average.
Well, I'm going to bottom of the spine here. Look out, my mom. Jay Mirons should be in first place after this run. He's thrown four big tricks right off the bat. There is an alley-oop drive, which he alley-oops up onto the rail and drives with both heads.
Up over the sub line. Very clean. Looks like he's found the rhythm of his line, Paul.
He is a competitor. He keeps his run in his line when he gets here. And he definitely has a plan. Jay Mirons, if he was not competing in blank for freestyle, he would most likely be in hockey.
Oh, yeah! Time expires on Jay Mirons. But he has lit up the place at the Newport Yachting Center here in Bicycle Freestyle Street.
Jay Mirons bangs out five big tricks, and here is the back foot. Look at the extension straight up and down. But when he comes down, the bike over-rotated once again to the right side and couldn't get his foot on the left pedal. He'll be scored high on that, even though he missed it. And this, the 360 over the spine, great height, and he comes down. Perfect transition.
You're on. The leader in the first run of the preliminary. Of the 20 riders on the roster for the street prelims, they're split into two heats. After the first round of Heat A, Jay Miron is on top. Still to come, Dennis McCoy, 10 consecutive times, an overall world pro champ.